My name is Dr. Ishmail Abdus-Saboor. I'm an assistant professor of biological sciences here at Columbia University's Zuckerman Mind-Brain Behavior Institute. And I'm interested in how we perceive our outside environment through our sensory world. The most important thing for us to understand about the brain is how the brain gives rise to mind. How is it that patterns of neural activity in the brain govern how we think, how we move, how we act, how we talk, how we treat one another? We think there's much to learn about how animals engage in their sensory world. The naked mole rat is one of the most highly social animals we've ever studied in the mammalian kingdom. We're interested in how their sensory world, their sensory systems, allow them to cooperate and have this really exquisite social structure where you have hundreds of animals working together, living together, cooperating. It's unclear why these animals don't experience some forms of pain, but we think that's another really fascinating thing to study. And no one's ever recorded or imaged in their brain in an awake, freely behaving scenario. So we think it could tell us really important things about social behaviors. So how is it that we're able to accomplish the science that we do? So I lead a team of wonderful scientists, postdoctoral fellows, PhD students, post-bac technicians, and undergraduates, and we really have an interdisciplinary collaborative team. I certainly can't do it all and rely upon the strength of the team that I lead for us to tackle the really big problems in pain sensory neurobiology. In addition to science, I really love teaching and mentorship. So the position I have here allows me to do the research I crave and love and also interact with a range of scholars across campus and also teach students. I think it's so important for students to be able to actualize themselves and seeing people who look like them. As I progress to different career ranks, you see less and less people who look like you and who come from similar backgrounds. And that certainly has led to challenges. And I've experienced sort of overt racism and discrimination and more things that are under the surface, systemic and unconscious bias. But through it all, I've been really fortunate to work in awesome environments and have mentors, allies who have really supported me, guided me, and, you know, despite the challenges that we still have to overcome, we've made lots of progress. We are necessary conduits back to our community to explain the science to folks. So we have important roles in the scientific enterprise and society at large. So we're necessary and needed, and I hope to see many more.